Hello everyone, today we are covering part 5 of chapter 9, that is MS Word 2010, right? So today's topics are about page formatting. So when we are talking about page formatting, it means we are talking about page size, orientation, margins and head and footer, right? So the first option is page size, right? To see the page size, we need to click the page layout tab, which is the fourth tab, and in the page setup group we have page size option. The moment we will click it, we will get to see various types of pages here with the fixed length and width, right? So the length and width which is fixed, it is defining the type of page, right? If the particular page is not fulfilling our requirement, we can change it, right? So whatever page you want, you can click, that page size will be open on your screen. And if you want to change the default setting, you need to click this last option, more page size, right? So we will get to see this page setup dialog box, right? We have one more method of opening this dialog box, that is by clicking at this corner arrow in the page setup group. So the same dialog box will open. Now we have three tabs here. First is margin, second is paper, third is layout. So the first option is page size. So here, from here we can choose the type of page whose setting we want to change, right? For example, I choose the letter page. So that page will come here. Now I can increase or decrease the width and height of the paper. So that kind of settings will be there on our page, right? We have option apply to whole document or to this point forward, right? So for example, we want the change from the 10th page onward. So we can choose this point onward, right? So we want to hold document and then we can click OK, right? So that page setting will be there on our screen. So that is about page size. So page size is done. Now next is orientation. So what is the meaning of orientation? Orientation means to change the direction of the page. So again, go to the page layout tab. We have second option in the page setup group, that is orientation. Either we want portrait or we want landscape. So this is, by default it is portrait, so we can change it in the landscape size, right? So that is a orientation of a page. Okay, so this is done. Now the next topic is margins. So page margins are the blank space around the edges of a paper. So these are the edges of the paper, and you can see this is the margin, left margin, top margin. So you see the right margin. So this is margins, right? So we have two options to set the margins. So setting the page margin using the ruler bar. So this is our ruler bar on the top. This is horizontal and this is vertical, right? So from here we can move these pointers to set the page, right? So you see, if I want to change the page setting, I can move this as per my requirement, right? So I want this to move more to this side, so it will be like that. I want to change the settings of this. So this is how we can move it, place the mouse pointer where you want to do the changes, and then move these markers here on the ruler bar. The same way we can change the horizontal bar for the top margins, right? So this is the one method, right? Second method is changing the margins using the page setup dialog box. So how we can open the page setup dialog box? Go in the page layout, open this by clicking in the corner, right? So first tab is margin. So whatever page you have chosen, you can change the top margin, left margin, right, bottom margin, right margin, right? So from here we can, you see in the preview it is showing the top margin is increasing to 2 inches, right? I want to increase the left margin, I can do so, right? So this is how this margin can be changed from the ruler bar or from the dialog box, right? So I hope you are clear with this. The last topic is header and footer, right? So students, you must have noticed that usually the title of the chapter is present at the top of the page and the page number appears at the bottom, right? So basically they are called header and footer, right? So they appear on almost all the pages. At the top, that is called header, at the bottom it is called footer, राइट. सो वी कैन इंसर्ट हेड एंड फुटर, राइट. सो फॉर इंसर्टिंग हेड एंड फुटर वी नीड टू क्लिक ऑन द थर्ड टैब, दैट इज इंसर्ट टैब, राइट. सो द मोमेंट वी विल क्लिक हेयर वी कैन सी हेड एंड फुटर ग्रुप हेयर, राइट. सो फॉर इंसर्टिंग अ हेडर वी कैन क्लिक हेयर इन द हेडर ड्रॉप डाउन मेन्यू. हेयर वी हैव सम बिल्ट इन और सैम्पल हेडर्स. सो वट एवर काइंड ऑफ हेडर वी वॉन्ट वी कैन चूज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई चूज दिस अल्फाबेट, राइट. सो वट एवर वी वॉन्ट वी कैन चूज. नाउ एट द बॉटम वी हैव एडिट हेडर ऑप्शन एंड वी ऑल्सो हैव रिमूव हेडर ऑप्शन, राइट. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिमूव इट वी कैन रिमूव इट, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू चेंज इट लेटर वी कैन डू सो बाई यूजिंग द एडिट हेडर ऑप्शन, राइट. सो फॉर नाउ आई चूज दिस ऑप्शन, राइट. एंड आई बाय डिफॉल्ट हेडर एंड फुटर टेक्स्ट इज रिटन देयर, सो आई विल चेंज इट टू एमएस वर्ड, राइट. सो दिस इज पार्ट टू, सो आई विल राइट पार्ट टू, राइट. सो आई हैव डन द हेडर फुटर, नाउ आई कैन क्लोज इट. सो दिस टेक्स्ट विल अपेयर इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द पेजेस. यू सी इट इज अपेयरिंग इन ऑल द पेजेस. आई हैव ओपन द पेज नंबर 5, so it is appearing there also, right. Now if I want to change edit it, I need to go to the insert tab. I'll click here again, I'll go to the edit header option, right. So here I can change the header, right. So I can write chapter 9, right. So I will close it now, right. So this is how we can insert the header and edit header. Now I want to remove it. I'll again go in the insert tab, header footer section, and remove header. So it's gone, right. So likewise you can insert the footer, right. So for inserting the footer we need to go to the footer tab. Same options are there: edit footer, remove footer. So for example I want to insert this. So this is page number 1, by default it is showing, so I'll close it. So it is page number 1, this is 2, this is 3, right. So this is how we can insert the footer. I hope you are clear with this. So today we learned about page formatting, which includes page size, orientation, margins and head and footer. I hope you are clear with this. Just practically try it, and if you have any doubt you can ask me. Keep learning, keep practicing, and God bless you all.